Hey everyone, this is Viren and welcome back to the MVP playlist on my YouTube channel. And in this video, we're going to discuss the Wizard of Oz MVP. And yes, it takes the name from the movie Wizard of Oz. And if you've not seen the movie, spoiler alert, in the movie, it turns out that there's just an old man sitting behind the curtains and using the levers to control the scary green head in the front, which turns out is just an illusion. And yes, that is the concept of the Wizard of Oz MVP. As far as the front is concerned, what the users see, you try and make a complete experience so that the user does not know what is actually going on behind the scenes. While behind the scenes, you could be running the show extremely manually without building a backend for yourself. Let's discuss this with an example. One of the good examples of the Wizard of Oz MVP is Aardvark, the Q&A platform where you can ask any question you want and they get a bunch of experts to answer the question for you. Now, while it looks like this is all driven by their internal algorithm, but in the early days of the companies when they could not afford to build the backend at that time, they had a bunch of interns answering all those questions for you. Now, as far as the user is concerned, it did seem like that something was actually at play and it was not people from within the same company who were actually answering those questions. And that is sort of the point of the MVP. It saved Aardvark a lot of money and development effort, and they could validate the idea very easily before they went all in. Another very classical example, which we've already discussed in one of the videos on this playlist, is that of Zappos. At the beginning of the company, the founder simply just went to shoe stores in the city and clicked pictures of shoes, put it up on a website. Now, as far as the website was concerned, to a user, it looked like a fully functional website with a backend developed as well. But in reality, when the user actually purchased the shoe, the team would just simply go into the same store again, buy that pair of shoes and ship it out to the user manually. The great advantage here is that you actually get to test out your scaled up version of the product without investing in building the complex backend. Thank you for watching this video. I'm going to come back in the next video to discuss another kind of MVP.